Hi, and welcome back to Genesis. We hope you've had a good week. Good afternoon. I'm Jo Tunnicliffe, and here's the lunchtime news. During the height of apartheid yesterday, whilst the Queen was being entertained, topless arms, the Duke bent over was After a short break, we go over to Robin Newhanson for the weather.
Genesis.
Hello. Sun, sun, sun is what we've been having this week, and what a lot of joy and happiness it's brought too.
For another action-packed hour of Genesis Television.
All in a day's work for the detractors.
In today's Genesis Lunchtime News, why over a million health workers step up their campaign for a pay rise? Will there be a breakthrough in medicine as a five-year-old boy recovers from the AIDS virus? And finally, more on the fishy war between Canada and Spain as talks begin in Brussels today on possible trade sanctions. Also, the Pope releases his latest encyclical, stating in a democracy that allows a culture of death, are heading towards totalitarianism. Please join me at 1 o'clock for more on these stories, plus the latest sports update and weather report.
Okay, what camera are we starting on, please?
So, what will you be doing tonight?
What camera?
Ever felt nervous or embarrassed about buying condoms? Don't worry, because you could be saving a life. For free and confidential advice about safe sex, come and see the college nurse in the Occupational Health Department.
Stand by for information transfer.
Hi, and welcome back to Genesis. For our third episode here at Farnborough Tech. We hope you've enjoyed the last couple that we've had. And as you can see, this week we're at Farnborough Cottage Hospital. Well, what have we got coming up then, Martin?
Well, today we've got two of Farnborough College's most promising comedy scriptwriters.
Yeah.
I forget their names.
Benson and Hodges, that's what we've got coming up. Ah, the doctor's with you at the moment.
Sorry. But no, they are very entertaining. I'm looking forward to that. It should be good fun.
Great.
And they've got their hodgepodge of soap operas, Le Village, which should be quite entertaining. And I think that's coming up any second now.
Uh-huh, and that's based upon the student village, of course. Also, we've got Movie Watch, but I will be talking to Justin Westernage about that, about the Oscars. And then, of course, we've got DJ Mixing and, of course, the news and weather with Joanne Tunnicliffe and Robin.
Let's go over to Le Village and Benson and Hodges now.
You're probably wondering why I'm saying my colleague's lines. That's because they've been dubbed over by the bad lip-sync company.
Yes, that's right. Yes, that's right.
Anyway, viewers, it's on to the first item. A new soap opera with high production values and first-class acting. Le Village. An everyday story about students. Le Village.
College circular. Damn! I don't believe it. This is outrageous. The college want to close down the village. I'm not standing for this. This is like a bad dream. But I'm awake. I'm going to stop this immediately. Damn!
Maybe it's because I'm a Londoner that I love London town. Maybe
Twiggle. How you doing, little darling?
All right, Pete, as usual.
Thanks, Gaylord. Lovely, thanks, darling. How you doing in the old China plate, mate, frog and toad apples and pears?
Yeah, not bad, not bad.
Lovely.
Damn, have you not seen this?
What's that then, Miss Precious?
They want to shut down the village. And set it to land developers.
Cool blimey, missus, and no mistaking. What's going to happen to me stone? Who's going to buy me wassels? I'll be stony moroke.
And me pub, I'll have no customers. I'll have to close up and go on the game.
This is an absolute disaster.
Oh, I don't know. I can do it, Mercer.
Yeah, do you mind?
We must form a battle plan to stop them. If only we knew what they were doing.
So that's my idea. What do you think?
Most ingenious old boy, but I hope you don't mind. I brought in Mrs. Maracus. Oh, here she is now. Hello, Mrs. Maracus. Tell us about your idea.
Hola, buenos dias. Es evidente, es difícil medir la extensión de los problemas de las drogas hoy en día. Lo que está claro es que el problema es creciente.
Ah, yes, I totally agree.
Bueno, no es importante de dónde van o si son inteligentes, toma droga por muchas razones.
I totally agree, mañana. You know, it's just much work.
Potatoes! Oh my God, my stool! I'm ready to order double yellow!
Hey, don't worry, Pete, have another prime!
Oh, thanks, well, you're lovely. Oi, Big Don, go and lock the stool for us a minute, will you, son?
What's on in Farnborough?
Nothing.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Wasn't it? I thought that was going to be really good. They built that up and they really did, and it was really very disappointing. I thought more of them.
Well,
what do you think, Justin?
It was great, isn't
it? Did it?
We loved it. So there, so there. And stop putting that camera in my cleavage, honestly.
No, that was all right.
Goodness me. Anyway, we're going to go and talk to Justin now. Justin Westmans is coming, and we're going to talk about the Oscars. What did you think about the Oscars then, Justin?
Well, the Oscars, I think, yet again, were a bit predictable for the major ones, like Tom Hanks winning Forrest Gump winning Best Picture, Zemeckis again. I think there's a bit more controversy about the Best Supporting Actor. A lot of people thought either Gary Sinise from Forrest Gump.
If I can just barge in here, unfortunately, I'm afraid we're going to have to go right over to the news. I know it's very interesting what you're saying there, Justin.
It's not the news.
It's not the news.
No, now, you just sit there and shut up.
Right,
it's not the news. We're going to have to go and run VT and watch the Oscars.
Your host for the 67th Annual Academy Awards, David Letterman.
And the Oscar goes to Diane Wiest and Bullets Over Broadway.
Well, Justin, what did you think of that? Were you pleased with the results this year?
I was happy because Forrest Gump won. I like Forrest Gump.
Well, they won six, didn't they?
I'm sorry, Martin, but your injuries are about to get worse.
Oh, no, we've been invaded.
Retract your comments, sir.
It's the head injury. I was really expecting it to be funny, though. Sorry.
The cheek of the man, I am not standing for this. I've got to sit down.
Excuse me.
Sorry, we're on later, aren't we, in the protractors?
Who are they? Who are they? Security.
I've got a terrible headache.
Oh, I'll sort it out.
Oh, will you? All right, I'm sorted for the night.
You
carry on. Don't mind us.
We'll go.
I've got a very sick man here.
You
carry on.
Get on with it. I'll sort you out later. It was an enema you wanted, wasn't it? Anyway, we'll get back to that about the Oscars.
It was quite predictable about Forrest Gump, I think. But not Jessica Lange. I thought Jodie Foster picking up again.
Right.
And I was saying about Samuel Jackson and Gary Sinise winning for Forrest Gump.
That's it.
And best sports champions, who that went to? That went to Bullets Over Broadway. I can't remember her name now.
I don't know. She won best actress.
No?
Did you actually get to see it then, Martin?
I stayed up all night, yeah. And I was drinking heavily, and then I left, and that's when I got knocked down and sustained all these injuries.
Oh, look at that.
Don't you look after this?
So, doctor? We're going to be shortly moving on to a feature about DJ mixing. That's coming up next. And we shall be seeing how to mix your discs properly by some professional DJs. But thanks very much for coming on, Justin, and talking about the Oscars. That's great. It's a nice little clip there. Anyway, we're going to go on to DJ mixing right now.